Hello, Gundam fans, this is Brown92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 High Grade Man Rowdy from Iron Blooded Orphans. This is the, kind of like the pirate's mobile suit that's used. There's a couple of them at least. And it's different. It has the look, like the resemblance of the Gushin, but it is its own little thing. It's like the baby version. It's a very simple color scheme going on, and very simple stickers. You got the one with the camera, but you can substitute for just the black, and then you can put the camera wherever you want with the other one. And everything else is plastic. You got thrusters in the back skirt, and the feet on the back there. You can't have a complete inner frame, but they do try to substitute it with the exposed pieces there, and in the stomach as well. Yeah, it holds together rather well. I do find the arms come off a little tweezly, because these polycap joints that are supposed to hinge forward are very tight. They don't really do that much anyways. So if you try to do it, I find the arm just kind of pops off, so that's really my only problem with it holding together. Other than that, it's pretty cool, and the feet actually work, if you want to call them feet. Yeah. So it's a neat little space pirate suit. Now, the head doesn't look like it can do much, and as it is, it really can't. But if you push it forward from the back and you lift up that head, then you can actually get it to rotate. But straight on, it doesn't really do a lot. And the arms, let's say, like I said before, you can kind of hinge them forward. This one's actually looser than that one. I think the polycap might be warped a little bit. But it does go forward a little bit, and it is ball-jointed. It's got a pretty long peg, so it does work pretty well, but it does come off the polycap ball joint very easily. You got a hinge and the shoulder armor, so the arms can really, they can go about that far, really. And then they rotate both the shoulder. They're double jointed at the elbow, but that's about as far as it goes. You got a ball joint wrist, which is really silken because the hands are pretty long at the wrist. So it's a pretty good veil. You got the ball-jointed waist and a hinge stomach. Ball-jointed front skirts you can separate. Hinge side skirts. And the legs can, they're solid there, but they go forward pretty well. And back some, out. Rotate the hip. You got a double-jointed knee. Now you wouldn't know though. And you have kind of a rocker with the feet, a little bit side to side, and the thrusters are ball-jointed, and so are the ones on the back. You can kind of get them to move. So yeah, you're not going to get anything amazing with this mobile suit. It's kind of like a heavy hitter. But you can do some things. So articulation, not that amazing, really. Well, this isn't going to take long because it has two accessories. You have the axe, I guess it's an axe, which simply goes in the hand. But they do show on the instructions you can have it like this, so then it's kind of like a hammer, I suppose. Oops. And then you have the, the gun, machine gun, I guess. Just two pieces of plastic, that's it. And it also goes very easily into the hand. And there. But the cool thing is, you can actually store it on the backpack. This little part here, you pull it out, and you got a little tab in that groove, so you can store both accessories. So you have a little gap at the bottom, so you can peg in the gun. It's pretty secure. Or, you got a gap here on the axe, or the hatchet, and you can peg that in. Not as secure as the gun, but it's pretty secure. So you can have one in each hand, or you can have one in the back. And that's pretty cool. It's very simple. And those are the accessories. It's very few, but they look good, and they actually work rather well in storage and in the hand. So they're fine. We're going to have a couple other things, but it's all right. So comparing this to other mobile suits from the line, you'll see that it is rather small Not very big at all. It's very pudgy, but it's squat. And that is the Man Rowdy. It is a very simple mole suit, easy build, rather quick. But it is kind of neat. I like the proportions, they're weird. I like the design of it. I like the weaponry, even though there's only two things, they're done rather well. Our articulation, I'd say it could be better, but with what it has, it's I don't really know what else they could do. I think for what it is, it's pretty decent. All in all, it's an average model, and it's not too bad at all. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to USA Gundam Store, and when you check out in the discount section, type PRIME92 with a capital P, save 5%. That's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.